Happy Sunday, everybody. It's Mark Coleman from Paul's Photo, the lab at Paul's Photo, and the Creative Photo Academy. It's day 325 of our Be Creative series, and let's talk about an interesting scene. So today, I had planned an amazing shot outdoors with the sun setting, and the clouds came in, and my sunset possibility was erased. So what do we have to do as a photographer? We have to retrench. So what did I find? A scene here. I've used this before early in the Be Creative series as my background, but I want to make the hearth, the fireplace, my study in shapes, and we're going to do this in black and white. So I've designed this as a black and white image. So you have the beautiful texture of the bricks. Got the plant, the fireplace tools here, the square of the fireplace. You can see here the composition in my shot. Is a very tight shot, so I've got the 24 to 70 millimeter lens at about 60 millimeters, and I've got the tripod low. The tripod set to about the middle point in the scene. Why is this important? Why do I have the lens zoomed in? Because I want to keep all these lines square. And if your tripod is not set perfectly, and that's why I shoot landscape photography on a tripod 95% of the time, I'm not going to get the lines square. Now, I know some of you say, well, in Lightroom and Photoshop, I can adjust it. You can adjust it, but it's never going to be perfect. It's always best when you set it up perfectly with the camera. So I've got the 24 to 70 lens at about 65 millimeters. Would I like to move back? Sure, but we're in the living room. There's not a lot of room here. So I've got the lens zoomed, I'm F11, I'm focusing here on the plant. Gonna give me about a quarter of a second exposure at F11. Why F11? Because I need enough depth of field to keep everything in the picture in focus. Now what I wanna show you though is a trick I'm gonna employ. So I'm gonna go ahead and take the picture. We're gonna look at the picture. And you notice when you look at the picture, what do you see first? I see the brass of the top of the hearth. And I don't want that to be the focus of the picture. Because remember, compositionally, your eye goes to the brightest thing first. So what am I going to do? I'm going to fix that. And how am I going to fix that? Some blue painter's masking tape. So I just got a roll of masking tape. And I'm just going to come right up in here. And I'm going to tape that brass line. Why am I doing this? For two reasons. Number one, the blue is darker than the brass, and the blue is not shiny. And I dare say that when I shoot this picture, you're not even going to be able to see that that's blue tape. Oh, yeah, you will, because I missed a little bit there. There we go. You're not even going to be able to see that that blue tape is blue, because this is going to be a black and white image. What we want is I want texture here, and I want to take the tone down. So this is going to be a black and white image. It may be a little bit brighter because optically it looks a little bit brighter than the brick. That's fine. It's just not going to be white. So let's reshoot the photo. Look at that. It's beautiful, right? It's going to be black and white when I'm done. It's going to have lots of tonality, lots of gradation in tone and shape and color and power. That's what we want. So what is your picture going to be today? And how are you going to be creative? Mark Coleman from Paul's Photo, the lab at Paul's Photo, and the Creative Photo Academy wishing you great pictures. And I can't wait to see what you do when you're creative.